Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Jurassic World Primal Ops, our brand new mobile app game. We're going to give the game another day, another couple of videos, see how we feel about it, see if anything else pops up along the way and how the story goes. I've got to say, by the way, the home music on this screen is actually kind of beautiful. I've really only just noticed as I sat here. I'm going to let it build up. Wait for it. Lovely stuff. Right, just to interrupt that entirely, I've got a new mail, very exciting. Participation in the wiki, well, that's the T-Rex thing, and that is already claimed, so delete red. Yeah, there we go, no problems. Now, there's a couple of different things I want to do today. In this video, we're going to try to focus on finishing off chapter one, so we've got three more missions left to do for that, shouldn't be too difficult. But I promised someone in the comment section yesterday that I would show you folks what is inside a chest. So obviously I haven't spent any money on the game. I actually can't spend any money on the game because the game thinks I'm in Finland. I'll talk about that in a moment. But we do have 295 amber that we've accrued just from playing the game in general. So we're going to buy ourselves a Jurassic crate. And then you guys can get a feel for what is likely to be contained in these crates if you ever wanted to buy one yourself. Let's go. Oh, I do like this little animation. I think this is pretty slick. It's pretty cool. All commons? Okay, so I got 9 Sungaripterus DNA. Okay, so let's talk about that. 9 Sungaripterus. Okay, to be fair, well, no, not to be fair. So that is about 4 euros. Now, that's a bit harsh because this is at the lowest tier, but it's 200 amber per crate. So that would have been about 4 euros if you wanted to do it like that, which I think seems like terrible value. The Jurassic crate times 5 is probably a much better deal because you're guaranteed to get epic DNA. So I'd recommend saving up for that, which obviously I know no longer can do so. Okay, right. Daily check-in. Nope, still day one. I'm recording this a little bit earlier than yesterday. So let's get started with our mission. I want to see if anything's happening with Fang Force, if things are going to mix up a little bit as we go along. And then I've got a little plan for the second video today as well. And then we'll decide how we feel after all of that. And it'll depend on you guys as well, of course. Here we go. Don't forget to replay repeatable missions to farm dinosaur shards. But the mission gives 1. What I'm hopeful is that maybe the higher difficulty missions, you know, there's medium and hard difficulties, maybe they reward higher levels of DNA. Great, you're here, unfortunately. So are more smugglers. We need you to hack a tower. They've upped their arsenal after the last few missions. Okay, let's see what we're dealing with here. I mean, I've already dealt with the bloody grenade launchers. What else are they going to have? I guess we'll find out. Hello? Poachers. Agatha, go! I said to myself today, what I'm gonna do. Oh. Is try to use the dinosaurs a little bit less. But it's a dinosaur game. It seems pointless. Go on, Bessie, you get him. I can't bother. Get him, girl! Yeah! Good lass. Absolutely smashed it. Okay, so a lot of the missions so far are pretty samey. Hacker communication. Oh god, I've taken so much damage already though. Jeez. This is what I get for not going crazy with the dinosaurs. I brought this on myself. Let that be a lesson to you. Always go crazy with the dinosaurs. Well, the Acro really does hang around. I'd love to unlock a new dinosaur as well. That's definitely high on the priority list. But what I'm really interested in is how are they going to mix up the difficulty? How are they going to mix up the mission structure? How are they going to... Because at the moment, it's a fun enough game to play for a little bit. It's nothing particularly special. I'll give more views later on. Oh, yeah. But I don't think it's going to convince many people to monetize, right? To spend money on the game right now. It doesn't feel like something that will be super popular or anything like that. So I'm hopeful the game is going to do something impressive to lure me in. If you want my money, you'll have to work for it. Dance for me, Primal Ops. Dance for me. Here we go. Nice and chill day. There's a bloody little My screen is filthy. Can't get rid of it. I think the new enemy is probably the grenade launcher guy. And the game kind of forgot that it already showed me them, essentially, is what I'm assuming. Angus is a monster, honestly. In the best way, of course. They also need to... This is what you got to keep in mind. This game is not out yet around the world. Oh, I want to talk about that. So, I've had so many comments in the last couple of videos asking how you get hold of the game early. People think I've got early access and stuff like that. I don't. The game is available. I think it's only iOS right now. And there might be a few countries that it's available. But the one country I know it's available is Finland. The game is definitely available in Finland. Now, you may be asking yourself... But I don't live in Finland, and best of such, you don't live in Finland. This is very true. However, it is very easy to make a Finnish iOS account. You just have to go into Apple, onto the online account thing. I'd recommend doing it on the web version initially, and make a Finnish account. Say you're from Finland, and when it asks you for payment stuff, you say none. You can't use your credit card or your debit card or your PayPal or anything like that because they're linked to your country, and Apple won't stand for that because they're silly. Well, no, it makes a lot of sense, don't get me wrong. Oh my god, hello. It's the tower! Hack and destroy. Why hack and destroy? What's the point in hacking if I'm destroying? Anyways. It's a lot of enemies. I don't need Bessie. That's a lot of enemies, jeez. Just keep shoving the dinosaurs in there. I don't feel like I'm doing anything. Bloody Nora. It's a bit hectic, this. Nice. Okay, we've got ourselves a little chest. Oh, got a little amber there. Very nice. Three pieces of amber from a chest. That's awesome. Anyway, so you can make a Finnish iOS account on the web version, blah, 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 blah. It'll ask you for an address and a phone number and stuff like that. And all I do, personally, when I do this, and I've done this several times... Oh, we got coordinates for a Fang Force operation nearby. Nice, let's go check out what Fang Force were up to. Fang Force, by the way, as someone pointed out on Twitter, it does sound like it's from Pokemon. Or, not from Pokemon, it does sound Pokemon, actually. But mainly, like, Power Rangers, that kind of thing. What did we get? Oh, I got a little bit of amber as well. Loads of coins, cool. What I do is I Google for, like, a shop in Finland or Canada, as I had to do in the past, for Durango. And... I picked like a Subway or something like that, like a Subway store or a McDonald's or something, and I just take the address and I take the phone number and the postcode, all the details, and you just take them, basically. Simple as that. Oh, we're working on Stegosaurus DNA today. Cool. Yeah, what just happened? Is that strange? Oh, was that an achievement? Yeah, it was. This resets in an hour. So we'll check this out in the next video. 24-hour countdown, play daily missions. What does that mean? Reach chapter 2 to unlock. Well, we're going to do that very soon, so... We'll keep on going. I do feel like the game is probably going to develop a little bit further. I think usually if a game releases in a very limited market, like it is doing now, you know, it's not out in the US, it's not out in... Here's one of the dinosaurs you were after. I don't see a dinosaur. We ran into some DFW stooges. I'm not a stooge. Damn you, Poacher 1. Poacher 2, that must be who's hiding in the trees. Let's take them out. Yes, look at me. Hiding in the trees. This feels a little bit like Pokemon. and Fang Force are Team Rocket. Because I've got my Pokemon that I'm sending into battle. And they're trying to poach all these other Pokemon. I'm surprised at this point that they're not trying to capture my Angus. You know, just like Team Rocket is so desperate to get a Pikachu. Maybe they're desperate to get an Acrocanthosaurus, you know? I want to open these things before... Oh, why? I finished. Why is Fang Force trafficking dinosaurs? Tell us... Oh, it's like a hostage situation. Break out the pliers. Why is Fang Force trafficking dinosaurs? Tell us now. They hired us to capture dinosaurs for their fighting rings.
Fighting rings? This is terrible.
We'll put these poachers away for a long, long time. He really did not hold up long under interrogation, did he? I always think I'd be pretty terrible at that. My pain tolerance isn't fantastic. If I was getting tortured, I'd be like, yeah, that's, it's all
Just, I'll tell you everything. Leave me alone, please. Just don't hurt me.
What was I going to say? I don't know. Fun times. Right, we are on the final mission of the sector. Oh, Ella. Oh, look at the colours. There she is. Remember, be gentle. She's just scared. Now, last time you said that, she tried to murder me, Omar. So I don't know if I trust you in this situation, but I will be very gentle. Nope, never mind. Whoa, she's a toughie. Well, she had to be, I suppose. Jeez, she really is tough. Wait, is there two of them? Oh god, there is two of them. Oh god, what, there's like five of them, what? Oh, I'm bleeding. Maybe it's like a poison effect. Cannon? This is actually pretty difficult. What is going on? This is madness. Don't know if it's meant to be a bleeder or poison. This is genuinely quite difficult. Unironically difficult. This don't do any damage. Right. Now, we just got a thing to analyze footprints, so I'm not going to disappear this time. We're going to have a little look around. Because I swear that wasn't there at the start of the level, right? Oh, sweet, okay. That wasn't there initially. Now I have to go back through the entire level looking for footprints. Alright, okay. Well, I'll do that, and then we'll finish the level off. That was genuinely hard. Like, I'm really surprised. Right, let's get this troodon. Oh, she's like the queen. She's actually got... She got like a little bit of a hump, a little bit of a sail at the back. She's like bright purple. She's got some yellow striping. She's very interesting coloration. Great job. We'll pick her up with the chopper. Yes, she'll find comfort in the DFW sanctuary. Job done, guys. Good job. High five. It's basically just me clapping once like a weirdo. Okay, cool. Give me some DNA. One! No, game! I was hyping you up, and now you've betrayed me with one piece of DNA. Oh, it's such a grind, man. There's got to be better ways. But hey, there we go. Chapter one completed. Cool. So what happens now? Nice. Oh, interesting. Okay, so it seems that... Oh, look at that. That's Stinging Moloch there. Ooh, what's this? Daily mission 1 out of 10. Sabotage daily mission. 9 hours, 9 minutes. What's that? Is that...
Oh. I've completely forgotten the name of the dinosaur.
What's it called? It's a not a Baryonyx, it's not a Spinosaurus, it's a... What's going on with my brain these days? It doesn't work anymore, I swear. It's a Suchomimus. So Suchomimus, there's... What, Pachyrhinosaurus? No, that's an Ankylosaurus. What am I about? Might just be Ankylosaurus, actually. Right, okay, so let's get started. This is no longer Fang Force, seemingly. Let's check out how things are gonna go. Quite interested, actually. So I'm also getting the impression that maybe you have to complete like the entire campaign on easy before you can then complete the entire campaign on hard, on medium, and then complete the entire campaign on hard. Basically, they've tripled the length of the game without having to do any work, essentially. Assuming that difficulties are just scaled up. Sometimes they're not. Sometimes the difficulty is, you know, rearranging of enemies and stuff like that. You never know. Oh, we're in a desert. Like Nevada or something. Hey, it's Brody! Hey, I'm Brody T. Bucker, paleo veterinarian and old friend of Owen Grady's. Looks like a Chad. I've been tracking the poachers up ahead. They trap dinosaurs. You're DFW, right? You gotta rescue her before she gets hurt. Okay, so whole new environment. Very cool. Free the Dracorex from the cave. Oh, are we gonna unlock a Dracorex? I do wanna see this stun effect. Oh, hello. Automatic rifle. Okay, mixing things up a little bit. go. Imagine if each level has a whole new... Oh, cheeky. Has a whole new thing, a whole new company. It could just be Fang Force, and that they've got like different team colours when they operate in different places around the world. They're like a football team, or a cheerleading squad, which I'm sure they would hate. They've got different team colours around the world. This is Fang Force USA, or Fang Force Nevada, Fang Force, you know, Wisconsin, Fang Force Florida, whatever. Not seeing this stun effect quite yet. We'll get there though, I'm sure. Right? Surely? Surely. The team power thing is a bit of a lie, because if you have a third dinosaur that you never use, like Bessie technically contributes my team power, but also she doesn't in a way. I really think upgrading your human might be the way to go. Because if you think about it... Eh! Upgrades aren't... Oh, there we go. Looks stunned. Cool. If you think about it, the longer you're alive... So the higher level you are, the more health you've got, right? The longer you're alive... Stunned again. The more time you have to recharge your dinosaur killing powers, essentially. Not dinosaur killing powers, obviously. That'd be mean. But your ability to summon dinosaurs. You're going to get more of that if you're alive for longer, so... I don't know. I'm not going to try to min-max this game quite yet. I don't think we're there at this point in time. But a slip and slide. I really like the sound effects. I know it's just a T-Rex and a Triceratops, which is a bit sad. You'd think they'd, you know, throw in a few extra sounds. I do get the feeling this game was made on a little bit of a budget. But I really, really like the Triceratops call from The Lost World. It's a really nice sound, so... It's not too sad. I am still very... So people have been asking, like, who's this made by? Because people are asking, like, is it made by Frontier and stuff? Because obviously it uses Frontier designs. And it's not. It's made by... I think they're called Behavior Interactive or something like that. It does tell me when I first load the game in, but I keep forgetting. It's definitely B something. I think it's Behavior something. Behavior Interactive. Who I've never heard of before. It's not Ludia. So this is, as I say last time, the first non-Ludia mobile game. She's in that cage. I hope those poachers haven't hurt her. Clear out the guards so we can pick her up without issues. No worries. But, I mean... people are suggesting they basically full-on stole Frontier's designs, and I suspect that's probably not the case. I suspect... So, what I know for a fact is that Universal, as in the owners of the Jurassic World franchise... Oh, look at that stun. It's actually super helpful. I know for a fact that they've got a... like a massive booklet, like a it might be a book, it might be a sheet or whatever. They've got like a dossier which contains all the dinosaurs that are allowed, all the creatures that are allowed in the franchise. It's like 800 creatures or something like that, but it's not every single species. There'll be some that are taken out for, like Thanos, which is a dinosaur, will not be allowed, for example. Let's rescue the Stiggy Moloch and I'll keep talking. Dracorex, even. Dracorex. I've got to stop calling it a Dracorex. It's Dracorex. Great job, we'll send a team over to pick... She's done a runner, mate. Hey, Brody's joining. Okay, cool. Definitely use the expertise, we'll be in touch. So they've got this big dossier, and I'm sure it contains not only the dinosaurs and the creatures, but also the skins and stuff like that, or the accepted ones at this point in time in the canon, or the more common ones, blah, 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 blah. Oh, cool, we got 25 Dracorex DNA. We should be able to get one pretty soon. And I got a new handler, I got Brody! Just makes me think of Homeland, so it's a very sad situation, really. Okay. Here he is. He's only level 1, so he has like no health. But we can level him up a little bit, because he's cheap to do so. Getting to level 3. What has he got? He's got a Trank Revolver, which has a stun. Medkit, which heals when calling a companion. A Stethoscope, which means does more damage with certain companions. And Amber Mosquito. 4.99% chance to restore AP when a companion defeats an enemy. I'm assuming AP is the dinosaur summoning ability. It actually does more damage than Mike Riley. Cool. Alright, well, like I said, I want to unlock this. Bam. One day, Stegosaurus. One day. What's going on in the shop? Why are you flashing at me? You're not. I'm not buying. I can't buy you. I'm sorry. Oh, I can open a crate with my. I've got 10 key card things. Let's do it. Let's open another crate. Now I really wish I'd waited before I spent all that amber. Oh, I see a rare. Hey, Proceratosaurus, Suchomimus, and a little bit more Suncorruptorus. Cool. So we always get 9 DNA by this, by the looks of things, anyway. Oh, I got a decent chunk of Suncorruptor. 12 Suncorruptorus DNA. Yeah, nice. Right, let's move on. So let's try out Brody T. Booker. Very curious. See if he plays any differently. Anyways, Kozlov Expeditions. Okay, this is a whole different shebang. Kozlov Expeditions, a company that arranges dinosaur safaris, have hired us to find their crashed helicopter and any survivors. Hacking the comms tower in the camp ahead, of course. Oh no, so this isn't the enemy though. So there's another company there, Kozlov Expeditions. They do dinosaur safaris, that makes sense. You'd go on a safari in Africa. You would probably go on a safari in North America if North America was filled with dinosaurs. Oh! Oh! What a man! What an absolute hero! Got a little pistol. It is worth noting, I'm definitely weaker by swapping to this character. Got a lot less health. He feels more nimble though. And the roll is awesome. Oh, Brody, you might be my man. I'm not sure. We'll have to wait and see. Might be the last, I don't know yet. Must have an open mind, folks. Oh, wait, am I doing tick damage? Is that me or is that one of my dinosaurs? I think it's a dinosaur. I'm feeling pretty good. The goal for this video is really to get the next mission done because it looks like we may unlock the Dracorex if we do so. Dracorex. Why do I want to say Dracorex? Dracorex sounds... It's weird. Dracorex sounds too... Harry Potter-ish, you know, and I'm like trying to just make it sound a little bit more fancy sounding. Dracorex. But I'm pretty sure it is Dracorex. Come on, buddy. I'm a bigger fan of a pistol than I am of a rifle. Like, aesthetically, it works for me. And then you can dual-wield pistols, which makes you an absolute baller, so... I think it's just because I grew up on Tomb Raider. And the Desert Eagles were, like, the best gun in the game. IMO. Yep, that might have been Tomb Raider 2, I don't remember. So good at this game. A little reference to that. So we're still in the same area, which is interesting. I need to actually have a look at the map. Some of you who live in America and are pretty good with geography will have to let me know. I don't really know US state geography. I used to be able to name every state because I did so for a competition for school to win a box of chocolates. Basically. It's basically the only reason I would ever learn such a thing, so. Chomp is a proper chomp, isn't it? So we've got more types though. The Ankylosaurus. I wonder if the Ankylosaurids and the Ceratopsids have the same moveset and idea and stuff like that. Maybe it'll be different. We must be close to the end by now. It's funny, between the cap and the backpack, I kind of just look like a school kid out for a little adventure. I just happen to be wandering into a massive poacher camp. There's the tower! Clear the area before attempting to hack it. You say hack. Every time I hack something, it blows up. Which I guess makes it more realistic to like films like Die Hard. You can actually see with Brody, because he's got really high power compared to Riley, the bar on the right actually fills up quicker for Brody than it does for Riley. So Brody's basically a better dinosaur summoner than Riley is, which I think actually probably suits me more given how I've been playing the game. So I think we'll probably stick with Brody now, but we'll see. Got the coordinates off the chopper. We'll scout the area and let you know when we find something. Cool beans. Cool beans. How cool are the beans? I don't know, you'll have to stick around to find out. Oh, sweet. Ah, look at that. You know what I mean? Okay, that is a Dracorex unlocked, essentially. That's the first time we've had an extra dinosaur.
check it out.
You know what? It actually looks okay. Doesn't look straight from Jurassic World Evolution. Quite like the skull shape. It doesn't have the like really weird wrinkly effect that a lot of the other dinosaurs in the game do. Actually looks alright. Okay, well, we have to check it out, surely. So this will be now a little quest to get more Draco Rex DNA, and it'll give me, like, none. That does suggest to me that in the next couple of missions, we're going to unlock a Suchomimus, which is pretty sweet. Right, so, let's have a look at our Draco. We can level it up. It's pretty cheap to get, like, the first couple of levels, so we'll just grab a couple of levels instantly. Malfoy, I'm going to call him Malfoy. I want to see Malfoy in all his glory. What an original name I came up with. I know, it's crazy. We've received reports of a wild Draco Rex in the area. Be careful, she's scared and might attack. I think we've been here before. And I'm going to get to the end and you're going to ask me to find these bloody footprints. Oh no, they're here. Okay, cool. We can find them along the way. Qua! Makes me very happy. Okay, cool. This is better because it means we have to... Hey, look at this little cheeky wooden bridge. I like that. We have to do a little bit of exploration now, you know? I think it's always a good thing. Which basically means what I do is ignore the arrow as much as possible. Not impressing me so far, Malfoy, I've got to say. Oh, Malfoy's actually cheaper though. I only just realised. Oh, interesting. That's the first time we've had a dinosaur that doesn't cost 4 points to summon. Go on, Malfoy. It's not a lot of damage. It's not bad. It feels very much like a one-on-one dinosaur, but I'd say it is less expensive to summon. That sounds like a really good thing. The problem is, even with the dinosaurs that cost 4, it's been super easy to summon them all the time. So, let's see. Look, I can't click it, but if we move away, come back. There you go. So, I mean, Bessie wasn't particularly useful either, so maybe it's better to have a 4. What I need is 2 threes and a 4, and then I can summon all of them at once. Like, literally simultaneously. Yeah! Get him! Everyone get in there. Everybody, get in here! I wonder if there are any more expensive. Like, maybe summoning a T-Rex would be like an 8 or something like that, or like a 6 or something a little bit more expensive. Something so that if you summoned it, you couldn't then summon another one of the same value. I do like having her around. Between her and Booker. Bucky? What's his name? It's probably not Bucky. Between that and my character, who's now called Bucky, it feels very easy to summon all three. Because obviously he gets his power quicker, and the Draco Rex is a little bit cheaper. It's not like it was difficult with Bessie either, but... Oh, there we go. Now, the third set of eggs, if I had to guess, footprints, I should say, is probably right at the end. I don't think you actually get anything extra for completing the side mission. I think it's literally the reward you get for opening the chests, right? The extra bit of DNA. I think that is literally your reward. So it's not a big deal, but there's no reason why you wouldn't, right? Gotta keep an eye out. Maybe there's more footprints. Come on, Angus. I can't name all my dinosaurs. I'm gonna have to make a list of my dinosaur names. What are you trying to remember? Quite a few. Oh, whoa, whoa. What is that? I'm on fire. That wasn't a barrel, I don't think. I think that guy's like a flame dude. It's the official name, by the way. He's a flame dude. That must be so terrifying for the poacher. That dude is fighting. There's an acro in the distance, sure, but the acro's not doing much. It's not getting that involved. He's shooting me. We're one on one. I'm trying to trank him. He's shooting me with a rifle. Oh, there we go. And then, out of absolutely nowhere, this massive Agujaceratops stomps out of the desert like a creature from Monster Hunter, dragging itself up from the depths of the sands and then rams him from behind.
Oh, it's green. I do like seeing the colours. Omar, stop telling me to be careful because she's scared. She's going to try to murder me. You know it, I know it, we all know it. I wonder if she's got friends as well. I hope she's got friends. Everyone should have friends. She's not that difficult though. She's doing a charge, like my one is. And it's proving pretty easy to dodge. I think Angus is probably my best, really. And I should probably... nice. I should probably prioritize him. There we go. Let's get you out of here, girl. Great job. We'll pick her up with the chopper. She'll find comfort in the DFW sanctuary. Which at this point is just like a zoo, essentially. Just a massive ark of some description. Yeah, back to getting one piece of DNA. Thank you so much for joining me. If you're enjoying this Primal Ops playthrough, please do throw me a like and some comments down below. I know some of you definitely are, some of you definitely aren't, and that's totally fine as well. Of course, we'll have our regular content fairly soon, but it's been nice for me to be able to just play a game. Does that make sense? I don't know. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers much of as always. Come back later on for the T-Rex event. Bye-bye. Reaching out.